Our performance has been very, very competitive despite a very tough trading environment. If you look at our revenue is up about 5.2% to essentially 21 billion rands for the period. So very, very strong. Our free cash flow, very, very strong at about 120%, better than the same period last year. Our EBITDA adjusted up about 3% to 5.3 billion rands. We've spent about 3 billion rands in capex in the period. Our adjusted HEPS up about 10.3%, and that excludes the VSP provision that we had. So overall, I'd probably say very, very competitive set of numbers, difficult trading environment.
Our financial performance demonstrates a number of key themes in the first half. Firstly, we continue to see our investment strategy bearing fruit, with mobile really driving the growth in the business. Our fixed business continued to decline, and therefore our mobile business has been really helpful compensating for the decline that we see in fixed voice business, which has really impacted the BCX environment specifically. The change in revenue mix as well is creating margin pressure in our business, particularly because the revenue streams from new businesses has lower margins when you compare it to the traditional business. So despite the tough economic environment, tough competition, I'm pleased to announce that we really have seen a solid set of results. As we indicated earlier, our operating revenue is showing strong growth, particularly due to the mobile service revenue growing at 54%. We also saw that our fixed data growth, even though it remained flat, it is really growing in the areas that we want to, because we're really migrating our customers from copper-based technology to newer technologies. So the growth that we're seeing in mobile has really compensated for, as I indicated, the decline that we see in fixed voice, which is declining at double digit. We are also able to contain our operating expenses to below inflation levels, thus really boosting our EBITDA growth at 2.9% with a margin of 25.5% relative to the previous year at 26.1%. And ladies and gentlemen, if I can indicate that these numbers that we're presenting do exclude the impact of our voluntary separation packages and voluntary early retirement packages of 282 million rand with a related tax impact of 80 million rand. Our headline earnings per share, if we exclude the VSP, the impact of VSP also increased by 10%. We spent less on our capex, at 3.3 billion rand. We also saw a good improvement in our free cash flow, primarily due to increased cash generated from operations, but also a decline in our capex.
A couple of things which will probably inform the strategic focus areas over the next 18 months or so. The first one, absolutely foremost, is managing the regulatory agenda. There's been a lot of talk around spectrum and spectrum allocation. It's a very important thing for us in terms of what it means, what process will be followed, what outcome is being sought with regards to spectrum, what objective is being sought, what is the intent. So we will be left front and center of this process in a way that hopefully it will not perpetuate the duopoly that you have in the market, where two dominant players, in a sense, have 90% of the revenues, number one. For us, it is important that whatever spectrum outcome needs to promote competition and investment. If it doesn't promote competition, if it doesn't enable investment, you know, the regulator might as well forget about lower prices. It's only competition that will give you lower prices. And if the competition landscape is not balanced and balanced in the right way, you will not have lower prices. So for us, therefore, we will scrum quite hard in that area. So the regulatory environment will certainly get a lot of our time. The second one is the mobile business. How do we accelerate it, and how do we drive the migration from copper to LTE or copper to fiber. So accelerate the growth, expand the network footprint, and accelerate the distribution. So those things for us are very, very important so that we can further unlock that growth and take advantage of the pricing umbrella that the duopoly provides. Now, number three, it's BCX. So really stabilize the machine, take costs out, manage the voice revenue decline, and really drive profitability. And I think the runway is beginning to open up a little bit in the BCX world, and I'm very confident the team will take control of that. And the same applies for, obviously, Yellow Pages. And then an overall sustainable cost management program. So how we manage, and you saw some of the numbers there, direct costs, how we manage cost of sales, how we manage network efficiency and optimization, because those are all the elements so that, you know, ideally we just don't want to default to people only. There's different buckets of costs, and how do we really make sure that we continue to strive becoming as efficient as we possibly can be, because that in itself will become a competitive advantage in the future. It's important for us as well that we look to retire the legacy network because it's quite costly to run a legacy network. So the sooner we can migrate customers away from legacy, the earlier we can be able to switch it off, we are able to take the costs associated with the legacy network, would have preserved the revenues. So there's logic in the madness in terms of why we're doing that. And obviously continue to look at staff optimization.